welcome back to the Lion's Den. This is Panzer King here. This is episode 2 of Secrets of the Lion's Den. And it's going to be probably a short one here, but I'm just going to briefly touch on and show you a new creation I've devised and made up. Some of you may immediately recognize some of these guys as ships that I had sent to Hilltop recently as a gift for him, and I know he really enjoyed it. Well, in this case, I actually did my own setup, finally got it done. I did his first and then I just finalized mine. And they're a little bit different than his, and I'll just go through. Basically, I did 6 Japanese aircraft carriers and 5 US carriers. And I kind of picked the most famous ones. The 6 carriers that were involved in the bombing of Pearl Harbor, and the 5 most common US carriers that were in the Pacific Theater from 1940, 41, 42, and onward. But and then I also picked 4 light carriers from each faction as well. Just ones, not names I picked, no specific reasoning for either or. It's just I wanted to obviously do some light carriers as well. And so I'm just going to explain why and what I did. Basically, you might notice the immediate difference here. And I'll just take the Saratoga here as an example. You can actually see on here from this plaque in comparison to, let's say, the Princeton, which is a light carrier, you may notice the obvious thing is that there's a chrome secondary backplate or border plate. And what I did this to represent capital ships. So when they're on the board, you can immediately notice, aha, capital ship right there because it's got the chrome backing. So eventually when I carry on and get more and more of these done, I'm going to move this on to battleships, heavy carriers as well. And this will just be my new standard. Obviously, they take up a lot of room on the board. So consequently, these might just be special occasions. I might just use them for other maps. I might use them for Global War. But I think it's so cool just to have the name on it. Like, it reminds me of that Charlton Heston movie, The Battle of Midway, the original one from the 70s, where, you know, you got the war rooms in both factions with the Japanese and the Americans, Yamamoto and Nimitz, you know, in their war rooms, plotting their carriers and everything. It was just so cool. It was one of my favorite movies when I was growing up as a child. And I kind of wanted to relive that. So anyways, let's just briefly go over each ship here and I'll show you some of the differences. Now, Saratoga and Lexington, these sculpts are actually true to it. You can actually see the Lexington and Saratoga. They actually have the large mast that they had, which was for those carriers. The bow is a bit different because these are the 43 versions. When the Saratoga got the retrofit, the Lexington never ever did because it went down and it sank. But you can see immediately there with the flags painted, or with the flags deckled on there, and then of course the magnets just to show you what positions they are. And the silver coating, the color code, to represent it's just a carrier, a fleet carrier. It's not a heavy carrier or a light carrier. And yeah, so I think they turned out really good. They were definitely 2 of my favorites I wanted to put in. But I also did the Hornet, Yorktown, and Enterprise. 3 of the most famous, definitely the Battle of Midway and Yorktown at the Coral Sea. These 2 right here, I believe, were part of Task Force 16, I think, and this was Task Force 17. But regardless, it doesn't really matter. You can see, though, once again, the sculpts are fairly accurate because the Yorktown is different than the Lexington, and the Hornet and the Enterprise, because obviously they were part of the same class, Yorktown class. And I think it was the Lexington class. Either way, there was only 2 ships in that class. But you can definitely see the difference there, just in the superstructure and the mass. And of course, the Lexington and Saratoga were longer in distance with the Hornet itself. So so ultimately, I was really happy how these turned out. Once again, silver coating, just to represent the ships in their, what class they are, if they're a fleet carrier or whatnot. And then you can see here, I just picked there was no real particular reasoning why. I'm going to be doing more of these, obviously, but I just figured I'd get some done up right now. And this is the Princeton, kind of a famous light carrier. St. Lo, definitely. Independence and Langley. Now, some of you may know that the Langley was actually CV-1. It was actually one of the first carriers the U.S. Navy had. But I did some research, and they actually did make a light carrier called Langley as well, too. So I figured, you know what, I want to add that too as well, because that's just a little bit of historical accuracy, especially by namesake anyways. So, and once again, simple, they're bronze or copper to represent kind of that third class or the light carrier with, of course, that one token. I believe these are actual Independence sculpts. I could be wrong, or Casablanca sculpts for these light carriers. I wasn't going to get too picky about the variations of the light carriers, because I know there was two major classes in the Second World War, but these ones I just kind of wanted to actually just get some real cool names on there, right? And of course I put the plates on it just because it's nice to know, you know, yeah, you might have lost some of your fleet carriers, but you still got a carrier. Well, which one? That's the Langley and the Independence, you know. Like I say, just a lot of fun, a lot of artistic value and fun when you can play this game and you actually have the names on the ships, right? And then, of course, we'll go to the Japanese light carriers. These ones, once again, no real particular order. I think these are the Ryuju class, I believe. I could be wrong, though. And, of course, I did name that one. And Chitose. I think this was, I mean, technically it was a light carrier, but it was also, I think it was a seaplane tender in the Second World War. And then, let's see, what do we got here? The Zuyo, which I believe it was in the Northern campaign attacking the Aleutians during the Battle of Midway. And then the Shoho, which was sunk in the Battle of the Coral Sea, but very famous light carrier. So yeah, these are a few of them that I wanted to add in. Once again, same thing, bronze, copper painting as well, but light. And of course, all of them, they have that nice foam backing too, so they're not going to scratch, and they nicely move, and they have a little bit of resistance as well. So yeah, those are some of the ones. I obviously, I got more to pick out, like the, I think it's the Hoshu and other ones I still want to do, because obviously I think Japan, when you play this game, you have three light carriers that are given to you, and I think one or two are already on the board, so I definitely am going to need to make more to fill the ranks for sure. And then of course we have the six main Japanese carriers of the Hirubutai, the Akagi, Kaga, Hiryo, and Soryo. Now I'll take these first four, and I'll leave these ones off to the side here for a second, because once again, all these sculpts are different. I want it to be historically accurate. Hilltop's ones are actually this style right here, and I'll get to that in a second. But the Akagi and the Kaga, which were the first two Japanese aircraft carriers, Kaga was always my favorite because it was big, it was different, and it was actually going to be, I think it was going to be a battle cruiser at one time. And of course, a lot of these ships were converted, and that way it was always cool to see kind of like their superstructure from the side, because you can see light through, and obviously the flight decks were added on and lengthened and whatnot. So yeah, I got these from Shapeways, but yeah, huge fan of it. And of course, I just painted some of the superstructure silver once again to represent the color coding there. Interesting fact too, the Hiryo and the Akaga were the only two carriers, I think definitely in the Japanese Navy, and I think probably for most other navies, where the flight bridge was actually on the left-hand side, and they realized afterwards that was a bad idea, because when planes were actually landing on the carriers, they had a tendency to veer in that direction if there was an accident or whatever. So that's why eventually the flight decks were all moved over to the other side on all the other carriers, like the Akaga and the Soryo. And once again, you can see the different sculpts. All of them are a little bit different here and there. They had the circles and the blood red spots in different variations on each carrier. But in these situations, I just wanted to kind of have some symmetry, but some difference as well to it. So definitely these carriers are obviously my favorite, because they're all unique, but they're also the four main Japanese aircraft carriers that were sunk in the Battle of Midway. And then of course, the last two here, these sculpts, are kind of the generic Axis and Allies sculpts, but I just assigned them to the Shokaku and the Zuikaku. These two were involved in the Battle of the Coral Sea, and both were basically taken out of the battle. These were not being able to used in the Battle of Midway because they got damaged and they were also attacked, so they had to retreat. And a little bit more damaged than others, right? I think this one fled, but this one was a little bit more damaged, and of course they lost the Shoho over there as well during the Battle of the Coral Sea. So it was kind of a tie, because not only that, the Japanese lost those, but also the Americans, you know, they lost the Lexington here, right, in the Battle of the Coral Sea. So anyways, just wanted to share this with you guys. Like I say, I try to keep these videos short, so if you guys only got 5, 10, 15, 20 minutes, hopefully you can go through the whole video and then you can see and enjoy it. I just wanted to give you a little touch on this, and reason why I did this, reason why I made these up was because I like historical accuracy, and you know what, ever since I was a kid, I was always playing with World War II toys or aircraft carriers or micro machines, and this kind of brings me back to my childhood, so it kind of brings some fun back in the world for me, for sure, right? Another side note too, just so you guys know, I mean, if you're in a C-zone here, and I mean, we can pick this C-zone, for instance, right here. It's not the most standardest one, and sometimes it's quite large. You know, the carrier takes up most of that C-zone, right? And especially if you have a second one in there. So what you can do is you can actually put ships on here, like submarines, destroyers, and then you can carry them around kind of as a mini base marker, right? But also, you don't even need to do that too. If you got 3 or 4 ships, I was thinking of actually making some larger plaques, maybe with Lexington and Saratoga on, so at least the capital ships can be in each C zone, and then their battle group can also be in that little that marker plaque, and off to the side, and you keep it off to the side of the board there, and then this way, then they become your fleet markers, but they also represent a carrier at the same time, right? So I'm toying around with that idea. I mean, I don't want to get too complicated with it, but I think it's so awesome to have the names of the aircraft carriers. Definitely on the board there, just to give it that realism. Because like I say, you are your own general in this war. We are not recreating the Second World War, because obviously we know how that ended. We're recreating your own way how to fight the Second World War and how things turned out. And you know, hopefully you can change history depending on what side and what faction you are on, right? So. Anyways, I just wanted to share that with you guys and hope you guys have a great week. And like, comment, subscribe, let me know what you guys think. If there's things or changes or comments, I want to hear criticism just as much as I want to hear any gratitude and compliments you guys give me, because you know what, that's how we all learn, that's how we move on with things and experiment and change things and make things better. So that's why I love this community, and that's why I wanted to share with this for you guys today. Anyways, Panzer King here in the Lion's Den, signing off. Take care, everybody.